Okay, this is a video to show how to power up a load, whether it be a light or a trunk release or a power window or a dome light or something. You gotta power up something on your vehicle with an output from an aftermarket alarm or like a remote start box or something like that. Usually the outputs out of those boxes are negative, 12 volts negative. And most things in vehicles are switched 12 volt positive. So how do you turn on and off an accessory with a negative output from an alarm or a remote start box? Well, you do it with a relay. So this is L for load, this is the load. Whether, in our case, I'm gonna show you an example using a light bulb, but it could be, like I said, a trunk release or whatever it may be. You take a relay like this, standard automotive style relay, and you've got the center posts are no different than a basic switch. If you look at the back of a toggle switch, there's either two or three posts. Some relays don't have this center, but this is basically a switch. And then these two outer ones are in a magnetic coil. And when you energize that magnetic coil with a switch or an output of an alarm, any way you energize this coil, it turns the switch, just like flipping a switch would on the dashboard with a manual toggle switch. So you would take your negative output from the remote aftermarket box and you would go to one side of the coil. Then the other side of the coil, which is usually terminal 85 or 86, these could be either way, it doesn't matter. You need a constant 12 volt in this example. You maybe would wire a relay differently for, say, electric fans or something that you're using a toggle switch for. This is only one example of how to wire a relay. Not all examples would be wired this way, but for converting a negative output into a positive output, this is how you would do it. So again, the negative to one side of the coil from your aftermarket box, then your positive would go to a 12 volt constant fused positive. Make sure everything in a vehicle is fused so you don't burn your vehicle down. And so then on the other, for the switching side, you would take your 12 volt load wire, and that would go to one side of the switching terminals, and then the other side would go to a constant 12 volt. So when we trigger this relay with the negative from the aftermarket box, all it's doing is transferring 12 volts from one terminal to the other terminal to power the light. So we're using the negative to trigger the relay, and the relay is just passing through 12 volt power from this side to this side. So I will give you the example here. I have a light bulb ready to go. I'm going to tape it down here so we don't, hopefully you can see that good. So then this is the relay. We'll take, like I said, we'll take a positive. Well, to start off, if this is what you were trying to do, this is your, say this is your negative. I use color-coded wires here, black for negative, red for positive, obviously. You can't turn that light on with a negative. It doesn't work. So you would take a constant 12 volt source and go to one half of the coil on the relay. Then you would take another 12 volt constant and put it on that terminal of the relay. And then you'd take your load, your 12 volt positive wire going to your load, whether it be a trunk release or a light bulb or whatever it may be, and put that on that side of the relay. And then here is your negative from that aftermarket alarm or remote start box, whatever it may be. So this is your output. So we are turning the relay on and off with the negative, but it's actually switching 12 volt positive to the load. In this case, for the example, it's a light. Hopefully you can see that with the bright lights on, that LED lights up. That's just a basic way to use a negative output to power a positively switched accessory in a vehicle. And like I said, you could do this with, you know, depending on the vehicle and depending how, you know, the vintage of the vehicle and how they used to wire things. Here's the I'll show you the diagram one last time. Depending on how they used to wire things and how they, you can alter this to fit your application, but this is the basics. And again, if you're gonna use a relay to power, say, your electric cooling fans, this would be different. Your two switching wires could be a real low gauge because the coil in the relay is a real low amperage, real low draw. So you could have real small switching wires, but then you would have like this one here, that the load power going in to actually feed the load, that would have to be a heavier gauge wire than your switch wires. So the wires going through the switching terminals would be heavy gauge, and the two wires going to your toggle switch on the dash would be lighter gauge. And that way the relay takes the big load of the fans, or, you know, nowadays we got LED lights, so lighting doesn't take much power. But back in the day with, you know, halogen off-road lights or whatever, you'd burn up toggle switches trying to power them. And that's where the relay comes in. So, but it would be wired differently. You wouldn't use the same scenario. You would just use, you know, you'd probably have a constant negative, and then your toggle switch on the dash, you would switch the positive instead of we're using the negative to switch it in this one. So anyway, just for good measure, I want to reiterate, just make sure that when you power anything that it's fused. It's got to be, all the positives got to be fused one way or another, whether you tap into an already fused circuit or if you create a new circuit from scratch, then you got to install a fuse. Just basically large enough to handle the load and not much bigger. So that way, if something happens, the fuse can pop and you don't burn your car down. So just make sure anytime you wire anything, you use a fuse. That'll conclude this video. Please rate, comment, and subscribe. And thanks for watching.